Fiona Lomu, David Campese, and Apartheid. South Africa's World Cup winning captain joining us from the back row, Francois Pienaar. So, were South Africa bad or Wales good?
I think it's... I think you can rightly say so. I think they were very good. They played with a lot of passion. They show some inventiveness. They played an Auckland-style rugby, and you could see Graham Hendry's hand and the whole affair. They played with a lot of passion. One or two controversial things happened in the match. The penalty try was definitely controversial. South Africa didn't have their day. They spoiled a lot of ball, basically because they were put under pressure, and I think that's a big wake-up call for them. The gap is closed tremendously. And it's great to see that the Welsh team has come back in such a way.
Now, here you are as player coach these days at Saracens, doing very well near the top of the Allied Dunbar Premiership at the moment, but in many people's eyes, sort of cast aside unceremoniously by the Springboks 3 years ago. When you watch a game like Saturday, are you just desperate to get out there?
Oh, yes. There's a lot of envy. You showed a clip of me singing the anthem. There's a buzz that you can't describe, especially in your own country. When you stand there and you sing the anthem, you're going to represent your country. It's amazing. It really is amazing. And you get that envy of wanting to do it again, because I didn't quit on my terms. You know, the last game I played for the Springboks, I was carried off the field concussed in Cape Town against the All Blacks. We were leading, I think, 18 points to 6. And since then, I haven't had a chance. Made the decision to come over here. I don't regret it one bit, but that's not the way that you want to end your career. And I think even when I'm 50 years old and I watch the guys play, I would be talking about those days, you know, when I was out there, my little boy, I'll be telling him how great I was, putting it on the edges, lying through my teeth.
You mentioned playing the All Blacks. I mean, there's that fantastic picture we got up there with you and Nelson Mandela on World Cup final day, which did seem, for everybody who was there and people watching all around the world, a day that was going to bring a better South Africa, that rugby was going to be a force for good. You must have had great hopes that day, which in the ensuing years were almost dashed, weren't they?
To an extent, yes. I mean, to describe the emotion and what happened in 6 weeks in South Africa would not do it justice. It was just an incredible time. Francois Pienaar was not known in the townships of Soweto and Khayelitsha in South Africa. After the World Cup, kids had my picture next to the president's picture, and that was fantastic. How can this happen? Sport was so powerful, and we could have launched a lot more on the back of sport. A lot of things did change, yes. It didn't go smooth sailing. I've still got a lot of positive views regarding the future of South Africa, and sport will play a major role.
There are two coloured players, one black player in the current South African tour party over here. But do you ever see rugby, which has always been the white man's sport, do you ever see it being fully multiracial in South Africa?
Yes, definitely. There's a lot of work to be done. You can't do enough. South African rugby football, you know, they've spent 56 million rand in the past couple of years on the developing of the game. There's a lot more that needs to be done. The guys that are in the team now, they deserve their place. They've come through the system. You've got to grow rugby at grassroots level. There's no fast-tracking system, unfortunately. And a lot of emphasis has got to go into school rugby. And you'll see a multiracial side, maybe in 5 years, maybe in 10 years' time. But I'm positive it will definitely happen.
But what was it like in the bad old days, in a sense? You were always seen as very much a liberal thinker. What was it like for you playing in the isolation era?
I was quite fortunate. When I came onto the scene and the senior circuit, as to speak, we were just coming through the isolation period. I remember as a kid watching the Flybomb tests in New Zealand and didn't really understand it, because you play rugby and I just want to play a game against anybody. Why should there be politics involved? I don't have strong views as a politician. I've just got views as a sports person. And it just, from then on, it actually fell into my lap. I came onto the circuit and apartheid was abolished, and we were playing international rugby. So I've been lucky. I've been in my life.
You say you don't see yourself as a politician, but many people see you as a politician in a rugby shirt in many ways, maybe on the back of what happened there. Do you have ambitions in that department in years to come?
No, not really. Not really. Not at this stage of my life. I haven't thought of it. I'll definitely would like to play a role in South African sporting future, because I'm crazy about the country, and the people in South Africa are crazy about sport. And I saw what sport did in the space of 1 year. After we won the World Cup, the soccer team played in the African Cup of Nations, unseeded, same as us, and they won it. And we went to the game, we were in the townships, and the feeling in South Africa is fantastic. I remember the day when we won the final, just driving back from the reception in the bus. What we saw in the streets of South Africa, you can't describe it. It's amazing. It was such a powerful event, and I'm so privileged that I was there to partake.
But you're so proud of your country, but you look at it now, big economic problems, almost endemic violence in some areas. Do you think that South Africa could stage football's World Cup safely in 8 years' time?
We've got the amenities to stage it, yes. The Rugby World Cup proved that. We've got fantastic facilities in South Africa. There's obviously the question about crime, and it is worrying, but I'm sure it's been addressed. And after you go into a major change like we've gone in South Africa, you're gonna get problems, and hopefully that would be smoothed over. We still should go for the bid, the same as we went for the Olympic bid. Those revenues are needed in South Africa. The currency is strengthening to an extent. It fell sharply when I came over here, and I couldn't believe the cost of living in London. I wanted to go home the next day. It is strengthening, and hopefully the powers being would put a blueprint plan that would serve the country.
One final rugby question, because obviously your mind is focused at the moment on events to do with Saracens and maybe a league championship and repeating your Tetley Bitter Cup triumph from last season. But in 12 months' time, we'll be in the middle of the World Cup. Do you think there's any possibility of a Northern Hemisphere team actually winning that?
Yes. Wales. I do think so, yes. You've got to look at the past World Cups. In the first World Cup in 87, New Zealand won it in New Zealand. The second World Cup in 91, England played in the final against Australia. The third one, we won it in South Africa. It's again in the Northern Hemisphere. The conditions will suit the players over here. It's in November, when the weather is bad, terrible, and not conducive to fast running rugby. And I just think we'll have to see how the Five Nations campaign pans out, and definitely how the Southern Hemisphere teams do in the ensuing test matches that are coming up against England, Scotland and Ireland. And then you'll have a fair view, but I think it is possible, and never ever cast away France. They've been playing superb rugby, they've got great athletes in their team. I just think after the World Cup here in 99, rugby will really take off in the Northern Hemisphere, because as a product, I think it can grow, yeah.
Well, let's hope you're right. Good to talk to you, as ever. Francois Pienaar, everybody. Francois mentioned South Africa against Scotland. It's live from Murrayfield on Grandstand on Saturday afternoon. And next.